Hi, my name is Abdul Fatia, and I work as a risk and safety consultant for BMD Asia Pacific in Singapore.
And I'm Andrzej Tuszynski, and I also work in the Singapore office as a maritime engineer.
The project was my idea. I have always been interested in helping others, so this is a good opportunity for me to lend a helping hand, which I would not have been able to do by myself.
When the Bridge of Hope won the BMD Giveback competition, I was asked by my office directors, Per Rood and Shu Kim Tan, to support AFTA in the engineering and technical part of this project. I was very pleased to do so, as I have always wanted to participate in a project that combines volunteering and civil engineering, whilst using my professional knowledge for the good of the people and communities that are less fortunate.
Last year, we visited a number of locations in Banten province of Western Java, Indonesia, in order to select the most appropriate site for the bridge. The selection was based on potential community benefit, technical feasibility, and the optimum conditions in terms of access. Out of the three visited locations, crossing the Ciliman River, which connects the village of Desa Mekarjaya and Desa Sukaresmi, offer the best prospect. The bridge will make a huge difference in quality of life of the villages. I choose Indonesia because this is my homeland. I know the bridge is desperately needed by the people. I also believe in the success of delivering this project with the capability BMD has in terms of funding and knowledge. We also have help from our local partner Yayasan Relawan Kampung Indonesia, a non-government organization who has a strong track record in delivering such projects. The bridge will ease the local community access to facilities such as school, markets, medical facility, etc. We hope that there will be no school day loss by the children who cannot cross the river, no loss of life due to not being able to access medical support on time, and no unsold farming crops due to high transport costs, resulting in local having to pay higher price. All of those will significantly change the life of locals, with new opportunities being created. At the beginning, there was almost no response from locals, as they were tired of receiving empty promises from the government for a bridge which never materialized. As the work is progressing, we are now able to get full commitment and support from village leaders, and we are starting to see the relief and excitement in the villagers' face. Optimism has returned, which is satisfying to see. We have a number of challenges and obstacles. However, the professional skill, spirit, and energy from the team is overcoming them all. We are still on schedule to meet the deadline, and at this stage, we are just starting construction work. We have experienced a few small delays due to soft soil condition at site, which require the introduction of new design features and new way of working for the team. We also expect some potential delay due to manual construction method relying on local labor rather than machinery. We have identified a plan to mitigate the delay by using off-site fabrication, which allow some bridge components to be fabricated at the same time as the civil work is progressing. So we hope the overall schedule can be maintained.
AFTA visits the site every 2 weeks. I visit on a monthly basis and I have taken part in 3 trips. The first one was to select the site, the second trip was to supervise soil investigation, and the most recent one was to review and discuss the design made by the NGO partner. A number of us here in the Singapore office are involved. Apart from myself and AFTA, our colleague Mutu Murugappan and directors Per and Shuking are involved, as well as Rizani Ghazi from BMT's Jakarta office. The team regularly gives an update on the current state of the project to Del Redvers, our own head of sustainability at BMT Group, during monthly conference calls. We are responsible for the execution of the project. As the initiator of the idea, AFTA is managing the project. He is the main point of contact with the NGO team working on site and makes sure that progress goes according to schedule and budget. Myself, I coordinate the technical part of this job and make sure that engineering-wise everything goes according to the industry codes and guidelines, as well as to our own BMT internal standards. I work closely with one of our structural engineers, Mutu, whose help is invaluable in terms of checking and advising on structural elements of the bridge. Rizani has led the social impact baseline and assessment work. Charity projects such as the Bridge of Hope help to define our corporate identity, showing the world that we as BMT are ethical, trustworthy, and different from our competition. And this can greatly improve our brand and reputation. Giving BMT employees a chance to give back to communities also helps to infuse a sense of pride in ourselves and our organization. Many of us are proud to work for a company that supports philanthropic programs, which can lead to increased loyalty and better staff retention. I believe that many of our staff want to volunteer or raise money but simply can't find time in their busy lives to do it, or maybe afraid to try an opportunity on their own. Employer-sponsored activities such as BMT Giveback allow us such opportunities.